Good morning, boys and girls of Calhoun Elementary School. This is Miss Amy coming to you with your first true music lesson of your social distance learning, and I hope you are having a wonderful week. In this lesson, I will challenge you to sing and make instruments of your choice at home. I hope to get some emails with some pictures or videos of you singing or playing those instruments. Hope you're having a wonderful week. Singing songs is always so much fun. It brings me such great joy. Nothing in the world makes me happier than music. Nothing in the world makes me happier than singing. So when I'm feeling down or when I'm feeling low, I grab a hairbrush and I sing as loud as possible. Now, that would be something really cool for me to see you doing. Grab those hairbrushes, grab those candlesticks, grab a spoon from the kitchen and sing your heart out. Or you can make some instruments. Now, I know many of you are like, I don't have instruments at my house. Never fear. I spent a little bit of time today making some instruments here at my house to show you how you can make some instruments at your house using things that you have at home already. Making your own colorful harmonica is simple and fun. All you need are some things that you probably have laying around your house. You'll need some straws, some scissors, and some tape. Once you've gathered your straws, your scissors, and your tape, you take the straws and you cut them into varying lengths. You want to make some that are long, and then you want to make the rest of them staggering going down until you have some small pieces on the end. You want to tape these together so that there's a flat top that you can blow across. The way you make the music is to take your lips and just lightly blow across the top. You have to listen closely. Another super fun and easy instrument to make is an egg shaker. You can make an egg shaker by taking plastic Easter eggs and filling them with things like rice, dried beans, or even coins to make a little jingle noise. So once you've found your plastic Easter eggs and you've filled them with the item of your choice, now I chose rice, you take your Easter eggs and you can shake those back and forth. Shaking these will help you practice things like keeping a steady rhythm. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Or just having lots of fun. Once you've mastered the art of making your egg shakers, you can take it a little further and make your very own maracas. Take your plastic Easter eggs, fill them with the item of your choice that makes the little shaking noise, and then put those Easter eggs between two plastic spoons. Put a little tape around the top and the bottom, and then you've got your own maracas. These are so much fun! If you want to have a little fun with a pitched percussion instrument, you can make your very own water xylophone. Now, this is so much fun, but you need to have your parents' permission before you get down any glasses. In order to make your water xylophone, you'll need some glasses from your kitchen, you'll need some water inside those glasses, and you'll need a spoon to tap the glasses. Now, I used some food coloring in order to make my water different colors, but that is definitely optional. So here is my water xylophone. I have three glasses here, and each is filled with water to different levels. I had to play around with the water a little bit to get the pitches that I wanted, but listen to what I can do once I get it just right. Instrument that I'll talk to you about today is a homemade drum. Now, in order to make a homemade drum, you'll need to find these items around your house. You'll need an empty can, a balloon, some tape, and a pencil. To make my drum, I used an empty can of peanuts that I had. I pulled the balloon across the top and I secured it with tape all the way around. Now, once it's been secured, I can bang on the top with my pencil and I have my very own homemade drum. I hope you choose to make this the best day of your life.